very fast freeze. It traps a little air bubbles within it. So the part that looks milky is a very fast freeze. The outer portion that's a little bit more clear is it being hit as the hail has fallen down a little bit lower on its way to the ground. It picks up some big liquid droplets. They froze a little bit more slowly. And they get the more like the glaze ice that we see in an ice storm. They get the more transparent hail pores. So that's one way that kind of milky to clear appearance can happen in the hailstones, and that's certainly a good example you showed us right there.
And Greg, there's a very solid relationship between the size of the hailstone and the strength of the updraft. It takes a lot of vertical motion to keep those hailstones in the air for that long.
Yeah, you have to suspend them like a levitating hockey puck, except it's a lot higher in the atmosphere, while the little droplets actually rise up and smack into the hailstone. The hail is just sort of being held there by its own weight against that very strong updraft, but the tiny little drops are rising up into that and then freezing in contact with it, and of course the whole hailstone is jostling around a little bit and getting a little spike.